Welcome back. The Nigerian government is looking for more ways to encourage more people to invest in the country's agriculture sector, which was once renowned as a top source of employment in the 60s. In this next report, we show you some of the challenges which one company faces in northern Nigeria as they try to boost the dairy sector and promote locally made milk and yogurt.
Dairy processing in Nigeria has been on a steady decline for a couple of years. For companies like INZ, they are managing to stay afloat as they grapple with infrastructure challenges and competition from the cheaper imported products. The LNZ factory dates back to 2006 and has grown to have a processing capacity of 20,000 liters of milk per day. The plant also processes yogurt as well, but officials have had huge difficulty in trying to grow the business.
We have the capacity to produce enough to feed not only Nigeria, but the entire West African sub-region. What is lacking is harnessing the milk at the right quantity, the right quality, and delivering to the processing plant at the right time.
Nigeria's Fulani cattle herders supply most of the milk here. They are known to roam in search of pasture and water for their animals. Hundreds have been killed in the past in clashes pitting the cattle herding and largely Muslim Fulani people against mostly Christian settled communities in Nigeria's volatile northeast. Most of them collect their milk in difficult conditions without proper facilities or equipment. Fulani herders also note that poor grass quality has led to low milk production, lack of storage and processing equipment, as well as poor cooling facilities, which also hampers milk trade. Lack of proper cooling systems make it impossible for proper milk storage, and farmers often face losses. To help farmers improve on their business, LNZ now goes out to their homes to collect milk. The fresh milk is collected twice a week, which is also tested before being weighed and purchased. While more upmarket areas have a ready market, poor infrastructure and transport networks also compound the cost of doing business. Electricity access and machinery needed to improve efficiency remains unattainable for many farmers in the country. Power cuts often cause losses for many milk suppliers.
Nigerians.
Well, the CEO of LNZ Integrated Farms Limited joins us on Network Africa right now. Mr. Mohammed Abubakar, thank you very much for joining us on Network Africa. Mr. Abubakar, I believe you can hear me. Thank you very much for joining us on the program. Now, we know that the government is looking to attract more investors in Nigeria's agriculture sector. But what kind of support are you getting from the government to help your business at the moment?
Hello, good afternoon, Cynthia.
Hi, good afternoon.
Good to be with you this afternoon.
Thank you very much. I will just ask the question again. I'm asking the kind of support that you're getting from the government since it's looking to attract more investors in the agriculture sector.
As you might have been informed or you are aware, the current Minister of Agri visited our farm along with the Executive Governor of Kano State. And we went around the farm. They saw our facilities. They saw our cattle upgrade program. They saw the facilities we have in collecting and preserving milk before processing. And the executive governor is willing, and he has told us that he's going to support the Fulanis to make sure that they give us the required volume of milk we need and at the right quality. In the same vein, the Minister of Agri also told us that whatever support we need, we're going to get it to make sure that we flood the country with milk, and this is our dream. Particularly lack of semen, which is critical in the upgrade program we've started. He assured us that he's going to come to our aid in that respect. More so when the bloodline of our cattle is approaching exotic And as you know, once the bloodline reaches the exotic level of animals that can only survive in the temperate region, we'll have problems. So we need to have a standard, just as obtained in India and other clients, where dairy business is at its peak. So we have high hope, and the Minister of Agri...
My next question is, one of the excerpts of what you said about it being rather criminal to allow importation of yogurt. And I'm asking now what is being done in the north to actually boost quality, because that's one of the complaints which we get, people opting to get products that are imported as opposed to what we make here in Nigeria. What steps are being taken to improve quality?
I don't know what the policy is on ground to protect we, the local dairy farmers. But I know because we are signatory to GATT, we cannot just close our borders to competition. But what I hope will happen, and maybe it's going to be gradual, is to lift, not to give forex.
Thank you very much for joining us.
The going rate by CBN to some.
Thank you very much for joining us on Network Africa, Mr. Abubakar. We appreciate your time. And finally, on the program, Kenya's athletics chief executive has been asked to step aside for 21 days pending an investigation into allegations that he sought bribes to reduce the doping bans of two Kenyan athletes who failed drug tests. This comes a week after Mr. Isaac Mwangi dismissed his fabrication accusations by Joy Sakari and Francisca Manunga that he'd asked each athlete for $24,000 to reduce their four-year bans. The two runners were caught doping in August at the World Championships in Beijing, where Kenya topped the medals table. And on that note, here is our question of the day. What are your thoughts about President Saul's decision to remain in power until 2019? Feel free to send us your feedback either via email or Twitter. The address and handle are right there on your screen. Thank you so much for watching Network Africa on Channels Television. I'm Cynthia Areh.